Check this guy out. He's a huge ass tree minotaur thingy with like red skulls. Oh my god, this is insane. Smash him. Hey guys, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3, episode number 16. Thank you for checking out this video, guys. So what happened last time? Pretty much getting our ass kicked in that new area, Farron Keep, absolutely getting owned by all those like little slug thingies, then going up against the stray demon, his absolute beast. We took him out first time, which I can't believe, which is like some kind of like good luck charm. And I think, yes, last episode, guys, was actually the first episode we did without dying, which was pretty damn weird as, you know, 15 episodes in and only the first, that was the only episode I got no deaths in. Man, shows how much I suck at this game, but you know what, we'll persist on, I guess, persist on indeed. So, if you can notice, I have got 267,000 souls to spend and 125 as well. Basically did a little bit of sunbrowing once again and got myself a little bit of souls. I have noticed I'm actually racking up on the good old sun medals at the moment, 16 at the moment, and that's sometimes even, the only thing is sometimes you can like go through the entire area and then like die at the boss fight and not get that sunlight medal, but you do get quite a few souls. But unfortunately I think the sunlight medal is quite far away from where we are actually at, so sorry, like giving you sunlight medal, so bit of a shame on that one. But a few things I wanted to do, I actually picked up a couple of things, guys, which might be pretty damn awesome. We picked up a long black bow of Farris. Basically in that Farron Keep area there's these like three massive dudes which are popped out with a bow, and one of them dropped this like awesome bow. It basically gives me like a three shot instead of it like a puncturing shot, gives me actually a three-shot combo, which isn't as good. Looks cool, looks like a Legolas kind of thing. And it's a bit more cooler, I think, a bit more on the whole, let's have a check of the old stats. Bit of a difference in the dexterity rating, so it gives me a bit more of a scaling, but the damage goes up a little bit. And the awesome thing we picked up, guys, was this hat, the Farris's hat. Basically, this looks like my Dark Souls 2 one, so I might wear this just for the fashion soul. It looks quite cool, I quite like this thing on. And this reminds me of the old, I think it was like the Hunter's hat on Dark Souls 2. Looks pretty damn badass. So we're going to keep that on. It looks kind of cool on the fashion souls. So what else are we going to do, guys? We actually have got a few bone shards, I suppose. I thought I might show you guys, basically showing like, the whole thing we're going to go through in this episode. We're going to burn all these bone shards. This is going to strengthen my SSS flask plus one. That's the first one I've actually got. I think I've got two of these things. Yep, SSS flask plus two, which is kind of sucky. Basically means I'm missing these out. And I did actually pick up a couple of things. These, I think like Umbral Ash, I think I've picked up. So I want to go talk to this woman. Well, my dash and one, how may I be of service? Give Umbral Ash. Let's do this. And then we've got Mortigan's Ash and Dream Chase. That's basically two ashes that we picked up from somewhere, which I'm presuming is going to help me out with a certain NPC or something. So let's rock this one. Mortigan's.
Passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
Righto. Oh man, can I talk to this thing and give it Umbral Ash and then the Dream Chaser's Ash?
Fashion one, what woeful Umbral Ash is this? This barren dust stuff of a fool won't yield aught. Where didst thou happen upon the stuff? Tell me for the sport.
So she didn't like that one. Tell me you found the ass, say nothing. Sure,
oh,
why not?
Yes, I see. Clinging to lofty dreams in this dying world, more's the pity. It must come from one most foolish indeed. Wouldst thou not agree?
Oh god, I thought you knew the best question then. I was like, oh god. Okay then, so this should help me out. Let's
Action
talk to her.
One, if my wares are not to thy satisfaction, bring me Umbral Ash.
Yeah, we gave you those. We just gave you two, my friend. What else do you want?
I'll fashion. Is it not our song?
Yep. So we got that. So we got actually, I think it's going to help me out a little bit now. She's going to actually sell a few more things. She sells me another three embers, which is awesome. A hidden blessing. Anything else I can spot out. Charcoal pine bundle. Human pine resin. Applies dark to a dark mind. Sweet. Dried fingers. A grave key. A key to a door in the undead settlement. This is what I'm actually going to buy, guys. Basically, I did unlock it online, actually. Oh, there's a composite bow here. Ooh, pretty sweet. And there's a like a merchant that I might be missing out on that I kind of don't want to miss. So let's buy this grave key for 1,500 souls. Soul arrow, Farron dart, daggers, short sword, scimitar, halberd, composite bow, sorcerer's staff. Nope, we're all good on these, I think. Anyway, this is the full leather set. This is actually what. Wow, this is awesome. This is actually I could wear that kind of stuff again if I wanted to. But you know what? I'm all good. I think. Anyway, I think wood arrows, feather arrows. What are feather arrows, eh? That's pretty cool. We've got like a feather arrows and the life ring raises maximum HP. So you know what? I'm all good on that one at the moment. there is a place I want to go, but there is a few things I wanted to do, guys. Basically, kind of like helping my character kind of like get set up, I think. I actually, when I got that stray demon, we actually got a soul from him, which I'm going to, if we can rock through here, talk to this guy once again.
Sure.
Any twisted souls? We do have a twisted soul, my friend. The soul of the stray demon actually counts, so you can actually trade these. The crusade demon, Deacons of the Deep, gives you a sorcery, which is quite cool, and it actually gives you a pyromancy. And then the soul of the deacons, this is actually a cleric's candlestick. This actually looked quite cool. It's a standard straight sword, like a thrusting one, and I'm presuming it's quite cool, but it gives you 12 in faith, you need to wield it, and it gives you 77 in magic damage as well, which is pretty damn sweet. And I don't think there's anything else we could show you out. I set this thing, the soul of the stray demon increases maximum load. I might buy this thing. I don't really buy many soul weapons, so let's just do the thing. Increase maximum load, 5,000 souls. Havel's ring, I'll take it anyway.
Now,
hopefully this should help me out a little bit. Let's roll down here like a pro. Check this thing out. So we're going to ditch the... Oh god, what we're going to ditch? The Flynn's ring is probably going to help me out. So let's put the on the Havel's ring, right? So what's that going to do me? 44%, really? Increase maximum load. Well, so you can knock me down 44%. So pretty significant, actually. So 44% I'm quite happy with. Got my little hunter's hat on, and I got these three weapons. I'm considering ditching the Sorcerer's Staff. How much will I be doing on this one? Yeah, I might even be considering, you know, to actually know anything about this armor. 40% now, awesome news. I'm actually considering putting quite a few points into Vitality to actually help me out a little bit, because I quite like to get under that 30% threshold if I can, because I always like to give you fast rolls. So there's one more thing we need to do with the old merchants.
Oh,
talk to this guy. Hello, my friend. Hello there. Talk to him.
What is it?
Basically,
I'm ready to go thieving it.
Basically, this guy just asked if he could go to, like, on his own pilgrimage, so I didn't really know what to do, so I just left it. This is when I was farming souls, so I thought, you know what, let's just wait for you guys to come back. I'll send him to pillage, so I'm sending him.
Grey rat the thief, until I ended up...
You're welcome, my friend, you are welcome. So this guy basically goes off somewhere.
Goodbye.
And I think he comes back after I've killed a certain boss, but then he should help me out. The only thing is, I know there's quite a complex kind of, like, quest systems with who you kill and who you don't kill, so I kind of don't want to kill any of them. Have I talked to this guy yet? I don't know if I have. My friend, are you friends?
Ooh, yet to give in, eh?
Check my little hat on, I love this hat.
The firekeeper must be twitching with delight. But what do you really know about these Lords of Cinder? These supposed legends? Let's take Aldrich for one. A right and proper cleric. Only he developed a habit of devouring men. He ate so many that he bloated like a drowned pig, then softened into sludge. So they stuck him in the Cathedral of the Deep, and they made him a Lord of Cinder, not for virtue, but for might. Such as a lord, I suppose. But here I ask, do we have a sodding chance?
Yeah, my friend. We could at least try it, I guess. It's still a damn chance. We're not doing too bad so far. I've got a lot of things to come, I guess. But and I don't think we've actually killed any of the Lords of India yet. I don't know if there's, like, we might have killed one of them, but I don't think so. So we've got basically a lot of things to do in this game. So the question is, you know what I might do, guys? I might upgrade this Lothric sword and get this to a... use this large time that we picked up. So, a reinforced weapon, let's go for this Lothric sword, 2 a plus large titanite shard, barbing this thing. So, we actually need 4 large titanite shards to make this a plus 5, but it's a plus 4 at the moment, which is pretty damn awesome, awesome
pretty
indeed.
Really
be careful, my friend. I'm going to be careful. So, I'm dead happy with that one. Let's rock through here, and let's spend the rest of my souls, and then maybe go for
welcome
this key that we
speak,
picked
then
up, then, guys. So, level up.
Very well. Then touch the
yep, let's do this, let's do this, let's do this, Fire Keepers. Rock through here. I'm going to put my vitality. What can I get this up to? Just as a question. 25. I could do with some decent vitality. You know what? Let's go up to 22. I really want to get some really decent rolls going on. And let's smash my endurance up to 25, vigor up to 25, and then maybe I'm considering luck. Or let's just do this. Oh, I could get that up to 25 if I wanted to. That'd be awesome. Gonna give my equipment a little up, and it's gonna give my resistances a little bit up as well, which is dead fine with me. I'm considering it, you know, let's just do it, let's go for it. Spending 260,000 souls, but yeah, 244,000 actually. So that's actually quite cool, and it actually cost me 26,000 to level up. Let's rock through here. How are we doing on the old weight front? Are we doing good? 35%, almost got it, guys, almost got it. So if I ditch my bow, we're on 31%, which is a little bit of a pain in the arse, because I really want to just get that under the threshold. Might consider, you know, whapping on another ring. That is with the Hell's Ring on though, so if I remove that, around 38%. which is a little bit sucky, but we do that for that Flynn's Ring, which is actually going to give me a significant damage boost if I get this thing a little bit lower. So what could we knock down? Could we knock the trousers down maybe to something really, really low? 30% if we wear the Cleric's trousers. What do we do? I could probably just do one more level and we got this thing. Cleric's trousers, how do we look with the Cleric's trousers on? Not too bad, I guess. Not too bad on the old-fashioned souls. 30%. So are we still on the heavy rolls? I think I'm on heavy rolls, right? Let's just swap this onto... Let's dish this and see if we got any faster. Ooh, I got really fast rolls. They had really fast rolls. Check out how quick we move around this one. Yeah, I really want to get my vitality down. Just one more point. Let's put the Cleric's trousers on. 30%. I do have two things equipped, though. You know what? I could actually swap these into another piece as well. Just to get me down. Just for the time being, I guess, until we get it. So if I got any for 29%, if we get any for 29%, 28% on the Master's Gloves. The thing is, I might get my ass kicked like really, really quickly, which kind of like sucks. Let's whack these on. 28%. How are we doing on the old-fashioned souls? Guess, kind of cool. I get some significantly fast rolls. Check how fast we go. Problem is, sometimes you can really struggle for a backstab because you get so far away from the damn dude. But let's rock on then, guys. Back actually into the action for a finally change. Let's go here, and then we're going to go to the, I don't know where we're going to go, guys. It's a little bit of a mystery. Let's go to Dilapidated Bridge. I think this is where we're going to rock on. Kill this massive-ass giant rat, I think. And this is actually going to free up the area that we picked up with that cell key. Basically, did a little bit of research because I didn't want to miss out on anything. Especially the early game, that we're kind of like the early-ish game, I guess. And I have been noticing we've been using that heal aid for ages now, and it could do with a decent heal if we could get the chance. And I definitely want to spend my sunlight medals at some point. So a little bit of backtracking, I guess. Going to this guy again. Back to the Dilapidated Bridge, where we killed the cursed greatwood guy, which is pretty damn sweet. I'm happy to be in this back area again. And then we're going to go back after Farron Keep again, guys, and hopefully get that last area cleared out. So let's rock through here. I've got my Estes to +2 now, which I'm dead happy with. Get some significant... Look how fast I go as well. Check this beast out. Awesome. I'm going to be absolutely owned, though, I bet you. I bet I'm just going to get my absolute ass kicked about everything because they're just doing so much damage. So we're going to rock through here. Smash this guy. You know what? Let's just try it. Let's try this guy. Oh, 75 damage. That's pretty damn sweet. And let's just try a little bit of a fire shot. Yep. So if you get 3 shots in this BHS, you might actually do some significant damage, which I'm really, really happy with. So I'm going to pop this guy with a bow. I do like having the bow on my hotbar, and I'm not that bothered about having the sorcerer's staff to give us that magic weapon, but having the talisman as well is going to help us out. So one more guy to kill, I think. Yep, there you are, my friend. Let's just rock down here and do the plunging attack, BHS. Smashing you out the way. Awesome news. So here's these guys coming up. I'm going to go for these guys. And smash this guy. Yep, sweet. One more guy to go. This guy going kicking his ass. And then this thing is what we're going to open. Yep. Use grape kick. Sweet. We have opened this door. Awesome news. Let's rock down here then. Whoa, God, I just fell down that. Thank God for that. I thought I was actually going to fall down some kind of cliff. This is actually the grave key that we wouldn't have found if we didn't found that ash from somewhere. But where does this go, eh? So this is a new area. We have an item here. We have a red-hilted halberd. Sweet, let's have a look at this halberd then we picked up and see if we're rocking on the old halberd fronts. Where Mr. Halberd, red-hilted halberd. I can actually wield this thing. Oh, no, I can't. Bit of a shame. Quite cool. And is it like red-hilted? Kind of a bit of red-hilted kind of thing. That looks like just a standard halberd, I guess. Pretty damn sweet though, guys. Halberds are pretty damn cool, but a little bit slow for me. So we've got a couple of ways to go. I might talk to this dead end thing actually, because this might be some way to go. Actually, this might be the person I'm freeing as well from this cell. Let's go through here, grab this item. Loincloth. What the hell's a loincloth, eh? Pretty damn weird. Is that something I can maybe wear? I don't think it is. Is this thing here? Worker's gloves? Nope. Nope. Oh no, was that it? There we go, loincloth basically gives me to one weight. Wow, check this beast out. And I don't have anything on. That's pretty much what it is. So let's whack these cleric drag. Oh no, the cleric trousers on, right? Yep, back the cleric trousers back on. And I can talk to this. Pray to the statue of Velka. Sure, why not? Request absolution. Request dissolution. What? Okay. You have not sinned. Okay. Request dissolution. You have not cursed. Okay then, my friend. Bye then. That was pretty damn weird. I actually thought that was actually an NPC. And it's some kind of statue for sins and curses. So pretty damn weird. I'm guessing the sins may be killing NPCs or something. And I don't have no idea what the curses are. Maybe invading. Whoa, pillage remains. Saw them run trailer. Picked up 2 guys. Skeletons in man. Whoa, check these bitches down. I took the smile guy from behind. Awesome news. Smash this guy out of the way. Christ almighty, these things going everywhere, my friends. Not very cool at all. Smash this guy out of the way. More damage for you. Sweet. Come on, bicycle collection. Where the hell were these? Yeah, more of these skeleton guys are all freaking everywhere. Well, it won't be Dark Souls if there were freaking guys in every single bloody area. Did we come from this way? Yeah, we came from this way. Fine by me. Rock through here. Where does this go? Is this go back down to that little pool thing underneath where we saw those, like, big guys with the shields, maybe? Probably. Let's just smash these guys. Go for these bitches, go for these bitches. Got some significant damage on these motherfuckers. Awesome news. No one's coming up behind me though. I wonder if these guys can't keep respawning. Just gonna smash through this shield sky. Ooh, police corpse. Human pine resin. Sweet, I'll take one of them. Let's go through here. I love having my bow on the back as well. And having this hat on, guys, awesome news. Dead happy I found this hat. I was basically when I killed those guys, I was like, oh, what's this hat? And then he was like, oh my god, it's the Dark Souls 2 Midnight hat. Awesome news. Let's pick this baby up. Chrysalis has been achieved. Attack this biatch. Go, 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 go. Charge here. I'm getting real close to this bitch ass. Oh my god, check how quick I am. Check how quick I am, guys. Oh my god, no, please not miss this thing. God, taking this big motherfucker down, sweet. A heavy gem, I'll take a heavy gem. And a tie light shard, I heard a dude. Whoa, that made me jump. That did make me jump, but you were fucking sucked for it, my friend. Get your ass kicked. Check that plunging attack out. My god, that absolutely was insane. Tie light shard just slamming down, man. But I'll take it anyway. This thing goes out of the question. Somehow I dodged it as well. That probably would have annihilated me in one shot. Proper significant damage, especially with me having like literally no armor on. And I got my ass kicked for it. So there, yeah, this is underneath this bridge. I think this is the guy with that giant hammer as well, which I couldn't actually find. Fine by me though, yeah, I think he's still up there. Actually, I might talk to this guy after I'm done. After I freed this woman. Be wary of mob enemy. Okay. So a mob enemy has been achieved. Well, they say be wary of, so, well, to be fair, there's something going on because there's not many dudes around. So let's do this thing. Here we go. Drop down here. I should have probably spent my eyes myself. Yep, there's some more rats here. You know what? Let's play the safe. Play the safe. Go with the bow. Go with this thing and pop this guy out of the thing. I'm using fire arrows at the moment, so I can actually do. Whoa, what the fuck's going on? There we go. I thought I was going to fire my arrows. I'm actually considering using this bow compared to the other bow that we found out. There's a compound bow as well now. So I'm expecting a mob enemy. Some kind of like rat sewers attack or something. Yep, a lot of dudes coming about. Yep, a lot of dudes inbound. A lot of dudes inbound. Rats, you ain't getting nowhere near me. Keep spamming these bitches. Christ, these rats are everywhere. There's a lot of rats everywhere. Rat swarm inbound. Sort of deserted corpse, I'll take one of those. Any more swarming for you? No? Nope, you didn't want the swarming. Awesome news, and I'll take that anyway. Saint's talisman, I'll take. Oh, is that another talisman that we picked up? That could be another talisman that we picked up, guys. Actually requires more faith, damn it. Unfaltering prayer, and that's actually probably going to help me out a little bit. Oh, the spell buff goes down there, which is a little bit of a shame. Maybe you're not better off with that one, you know. Because what I'm trying to do is trying to just get that little quick heal off. And if I can't do that because the buff isn't as good, then screw that. But you know what? No harm in trying it out. I definitely know I need to have more points into faith if I'm going to actually use any of these miracles that we've been using the sunlight medals for. Don't get me wrong, I'm not really that bothered about the sunlight medals. It's more about helping out other people. And sunburrowing, but we might as well take it because they normally are quite decent things. So we got to talk to this thing. We actually freed this woman.
Who is that?
It's midnight with an awesome hat.
Someone
check
there?
It out.
Anyone? Oh, please, whoever you are, touch me. The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh. Little creatures, they never stop biting. So please, hold out your hand and touch me.
Sure thing, touch it. She lets a little bit of a touch up, right then. Right then, if that's how you roll, that's how I roll.
Oh, yes, there you are. So
a little bit,
close,
a little bit of compassion going
indeed.
On.
Indeed. Then I am not entirely alone just yet. Praise the merciful gods above.
Prayer is my little emotion that I picked up.
Oh,
okay.
Forgive me. I am Irina of Karim. I came to this land so that I might be a firekeeper. Your touch has freed me from the darkness. You are a champion, then?
Not really. I've only killed like two bosses so far.
And unfit to tend the flames. But if it would not trouble you, might I enter into your service instead?
Sure thing, accept a service,
oh,
why not?
Thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Karim, solemnly swear to serve you.
By the old gods and the new, right? Sweet, so she kind of like did an awesome like teleport kind of thing going off. Let's just rock through here then, smash this barrel out the way. Open this door up, I hope. Presume I'm going to talk to this guy and might have some new dialogue for me. You're welcome, my friend.
You've gone and rescued her, have you?
We did indeed. We did indeed. She kind of like teleported out of here, I'm afraid.
Very quaint. Pitying creatures that are beyond help.
You're nice. This guy's hammer's huge.
Very well. I'm sick of looking after her at any rate.
What did you do? You were trapped her up or something, didn't you?
I am Egon. A knight of Karim.
Ah, she was a knight.
I am allied to you for as long as you assure the girl's safety. And only for that long.
Wow.
What's okay, the matter? Then... My terms are very simple. I am allied to you for as long as you assure the girl's safety. And only...
Okay then, so this guy seems to be helping me out until I, Until she kind of like walks off. So let's pop a homeward bone. Get the hell out of this. Shrine bonfire and bonfire. Let's rest it out. Shrine bonfire. Let's get back through here. Back to Farron Keep. Pretty damn weird though. Freeing that girl. Actually, I wonder if I could maybe even speak to that girl. Now she might even be back at Firelink. But that Aegon guy, he was a knight protecting her. Well, she was in a damn cell. You weren't doing that. Girl. You should have damn freed her in a, let her escape or something. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe he was guarding the cell. But now he's going to be allied with me until I don't need her anymore. She doesn't need me anymore. So let's try and see if we can find this woman out. Hello there, little teleporting cleric woman. Are you around anywhere? Plunging attack for your bitch ass. Nope. Let's find a doctor's thing. Welcome back. Nice little teleport, by the way.
I was not meant to be a firekeeper, but I am honored to serve you beside the bonfire. The gods are ever merciful. My gratitude lies with them and with you. I am yours now. Your wish is my command.
Okay then, could you give me a plus 10 Lothric Knight sword? That'd be awesome. Learn miracles, purchase item, give divine tome. What the hell? Sure. Oh wow, because we're actually missing these people out. This is what I'm saying. You've already missed these two things. We've already picked up these tomes. And because I didn't see this woman, I wouldn't know be able to give this woman out.
Brought me a braille divine tome.
So here you go, you're a tome for you, and then here's another tome coming up.
Now I can tell new tales of miracles.
Sweet, that's quite a cool way of doing the quest, actually.
Tales of the greater miracles can be quite the epics. What fun we will have.
You're welcome. I've got another one right here for you.
What's this? Champion of Ash, this divine tome is forbidden. These are dark tales of things that lurk deep within men. These stories would not please you. Of course, if you insist, I will read them for you. Only... they frighten me so.
Okay, pretty strange.
The little creatures that nibble at me in the darkness.
So can I talk to someone?
No, in my home of Karim, I was a nun. I would be pleased to share the tales of miracles with you. Although, to be honest, I only know a few. But if I had a divine tome, I could tell you many tales.
I just did those tomes, man. Come on!
Oh, only I cannot see.
Righto, can I talk to you once more?
Sorry. But you'll have to find me a divine tome in
braille. I'm pretty sure, unless you've got short-term memory loss, I just gave you two tomes in a row.
No,
come on.
In my home,
We've already talked this. Okay. Learn miracles, purchase item. Purchase item. The Saint's Ring allows me attunement of additional spell. That's pretty damn sweet. And anything else you sell? Nope, you don't sell damn all. Okay then, my friend. Learn miracles. Okay, so with this, the miracles that I've been looking forward to is try and basically get a few things rocking. So we've got these. These are basically kind of like hexes. So you summon insect swarm and summon extra attack, absorption, resist stamina, recovery. Pretty strange. Force, create shockwave, returns cast to the last bonfire rested or to shrine, that's homeward. Tears of denial, grants one chance to endure while HP reduces zero. That's pretty damn sweet. You only require 15 faith as well. Basically gives you a second chance if you go down. You've got one shot to regen up, which is pretty damn sweet. Caressing tears, cures ailments for self and vicinity. That's pretty damn cool then. If you wanted to be like a bit of a sombro, all these miracles are down to help you out. Gradually restores HP for replenishment, that's 15 faith. Medium heal, restores moderate HP for self and vicinity. And heal, restores HP for self and vicinity once again. So I'm considering medium heal, you know what I mean? 15 faith, That's not too far away. Let's buy this baby. And maybe even buy Caressing Tears. Why not? 1,500 souls. Quite like that idea of that one. Fortunately, though, I can't even increase my faith. What level actually am I at the moment? Let's check out my old stats. So we're level 67, and we need another 5 points into faith, which is quite significant, which is a bit of a shame. Nothing I can do about that one. So maybe that'll be something for the future, even requiring a 12th faith for like the first heal as well, which is a little bit of a shame. I probably should buy that one as well. But let's rock on, back to Farron Keep. Back to where we're at, I guess. Going after this last chimney. So where are we? Is it here? No, it's at Old Wolf of Farron. So we actually did pick up this Covenant, the Wolf Covenant, which is basically like an invading one. It's kind of like the Knight of the Rat Bros, I think, anyway. You're kind of like protecting this area, which is pretty damn sweet, but not for me. I know you can get the little metal things. There's like a little bit of a rare drop from the actual like weird minotaur things that we've been fighting, but don't need any at the moment. Kicking ass at the Sunbro. I'm considering swapping back into the Blue Sentinels or something, but you know what? I quite like being in the Sunbros, and when we finally get to that Sunlight Altar, hopefully it's not too... It'd kind of be a bit sucky, if I'm honest, if it's like really far in the game, because you kind of just want to explore your Sunlight medals and get you some good stuff. But obviously, the faith in 2 minutes is going to cost me ridiculous amounts, which is a little bit of a shame. So let's rock through here. I do know these purple moss clumps that we've been picking up reduces poison, so I could actually pop one of these at some point. And let's get it. Oh my god, I forgot all these slug things are after me like a fucking bitch ass. Take my motherfuckers down, Christ almighty. Take all these motherfuckers down. But I've got to go through here. I kind of don't worry about the items. Let's run as quick as we can. I don't know if actually rolling is going to help me out, you know. This poison's actually going to be significantly building up. Yep, a lot of these dudes around here. Let's go through here, picking this up. My Titanite Shard. Did I actually give my Estuses in? I don't think I've still got an Estus Shard, you know. Whoa, what that guy as well. Check that guy out. Oh my god. Poison everywhere. Let's roll through here. Check out this poison. Christ almighty, I was almost poisoned then. That would have been significantly bad. So we've got this guy to kill. You know what? I'm going to run through here. Please don't poison me. Oh my god, no. Oh Christ, check out that ball. That was proper damn insane. Okay, so we've got this guy. I think I've already fought one of these guys basically in co-op. They are a bit of a bitch. So here we go. Let's pop these motherfuckers. Only one shot. That was kind of sucky. Oh my god, check the motherfucker down. Check this guy out. He's a huge ass tree minotaur thingy with like red skulls. Oh my god, this is insane. Smash him. A little bit of damage to you. Whoa. Damage. Okay, these red skulls basically like AoE you. And they like track you down as well. Proper damn insane. And I've got to watch this poison because I'm in the damn swamp. Poison. No thank you. Damage. And damage again. Oh my god, that shockwave was insane. Insane shockwave thingy. That was a little bit cheap, my friend. A little bit cheap. Go for him. It goes down, but I got significant chunks of health lost off me, my god. Because of that damn bloody red skull thingy. One of these motherfuckers goes down, which I'm happy with. You know what? I'm going to pop a purple musk. Actually, no, screw it. Let's go through it. If I get poisoned, I get poisoned. This Estus, though, is actually helping me out. I don't know if you noticed, but that's... yeah, I'm poisoned now, but now I can actually explore these areas. Which is a little bit fine by me. Explore these areas without being too worried about the poison. But having that plus 2 version of those Estus actually helped me out significantly. So hopefully it's actually going to help me out in the long run. Bit of a shame that we didn't find those bone shards any earlier. Basically, I found one near that dilapidated bridge, actually, where we found that arrow guy for the first time. And I think we found one in this area. I'm not sure, actually. Let's go rock through here. We've got this one. We got the Nameless Knight full set, which is pretty damn sweet. I'll be checking that out as soon as I get out of this poison area. But having that that miracle, what we picked up. Invaded by Dark Spirit, Yellowfinger Hyzel. Okay, then, Yellowfinger Hyzel. You're not Redfinger or anything, my friend. Okay, let's do this then. Let's do this, Yellowfinger. Where are you at? I'm ready for you, my friend. Are you... I wonder if I could spot him out. Let's do this then, my friend. Where are you? Come on, let's go. You know what? I could pop a magic weapon on this thing. You know what? Let's do it. Real quick spammy. Where's the Sorcerer's Staff at? Thank God for that. Sorcerer's Staff has been achieved. Get in. Pop of this one. Magic weapon. Oh my god. Nope. Not this one. Magic weapon is me. I'll fuck up. Sweet. So I've got magic weapon on. Let's ditch my Sorcerer's Staff again. 28% for you, my friend. 28%. Ready to roll. Come on, Yellowfinger. I'm ready for you, my friend. So I'm still poisoned. There's another one of these tree things. I'm going to have to go for this motherfucker. Oh my god. I'm really slow in this water. I do not like being this slow. Let's get out of here. Drag this guy towards me, maybe. This guy kicks my ass. Nope. Okay. Pop an Estus. Run through here. Oh my god, check this guy out. I'm gonna get crushed behind him or something. Some significant damage. Oh my god, nope. Come on, I don't want to die in this episode. I want to make it two episodes in a row without dying. Pop an Estus. Let's go through here. I've got a lot of ground, this guy now, though. A lot of ground. Quite happy I popped some magic weapon, actually, because this is going to help me out a little bit. Nope, smashing you. No damage for you. You're literally a little back, little tree leg thingy. One more damage, I'm going to go through now. Got that shockwave off again. Freaking hell, I can't tell where this guy actually plays, this motherfucker. Let's go through here. Wait for this thing to come down. And again, yep. Because there's slow rolls, I can get some significant rolling going on. Significant rolling. Which I'm dead happy with. Pop an Estus. Let's rock through here with a little bit more progress, right? So I'm ready for yellow thing to pop me out. Another two homeward bones there. This poison is still ticking me down. Okay, our poison lasts forever in this game now. This is the last chimney achieved, right? Yep, last chimney achieved. Guess in. Extinguish this flame. And that should be the door to Wolf's Blood. Is it Wolf's Blood? I think it was Wolf's Blood. Open now. Get in. Smash this little chimney out of the way. Which is fine by me. We've picked up two last episode and getting this one this episode. Opening that door up. So let's rock on a bit further on then, guys. And see how we can get on. Expecting yellow fingers. Yep, that's the door opening up now. Awesome news. No idea how that opens up. Some kind of like awesome electrical torch-like system. I've got no idea how the hell that happens. But I'll take it anyway. That is Dark Souls. A lot of things don't make sense in Dark Souls. But you know what? That's why you play, because it's freaking awesome. Most of the time, when I get my ass kicked all the time. Well, I say most of the time, all the time for me, I'm getting my ass kicked. But we'll try it out. Persistence. And with our little hunters out, we might have a bit of good luck going on. Let's rock back down through here then. I'm waiting for Yellowfinger to like invade me. But if you ain't going to like go anywhere near me, I'm not going to be bothered. I'm just going to keep running. I don't need to fight this guy. I know he'll come back at some point. I think anyway. Sometimes they do give you a bit of a decent loot drop. You know what? I might have a little bit of an explore for him. Where are you at, my friend? Let's do this. I'm not really bothered about poison. I've got three Esters left to use, though. To be fair, I could get my ass kicked by bloody Yellowfinger, and that could be it. Where the hell is he? I can't even tell where he is. You know, he's, like, completely far away. Four of these slugs around here. I'm getting my poison build up. You know what? Let's pop a purple moss. And there's this doorway over here, actually, as well. Actually, you know what? I don't want to go too far away from this area. So I'm just going to go through here. This purple moss is actually going to screw me up now, because I'm actually already poisoned. Which is a little bit of a shame. Let's rock through here. Poison is going to screw me up. Poison is going to screw me up. Keep going. Let's get out of this area. Doesn't do too much of a tick down as well. I'm not worried about Yellowfinger invading me anymore. See, happy got these like new setup as well, guys. Let's go through here. Think back towards the Wolf's Blood area, right? I think that's where we're going anyway. Follow the bonfires along. A bit of a jump attack for you. Sweet. Don't worry about the poison. I wonder if he's like near the... He might even be near the doorway, you know. That could be a little bit of a cheeky spot for you, my friend. Go through here. See your little sluggy thingies. You didn't see that one, did you? You didn't see that one, bitches. Let's get up the hell out of this one. Yeah, he could even be back to this area. I'm considering going back to the bonfire as well. That could be a good idea. Yeah, you know what? Let's rest up. Why not? May as well. Let's go through here. Get ourselves rested up. Bit of a tactical move going on. Back through here. Still got my Ash and Esters to use as well. I am considering... You know, popping a ditch of my Ash and Estus, or even having two Ash and Estus, sorry. And why can't I rest? Oh, I can't rest because the guy's invading me, that's why, man. So I was trying to do my little tactical move, but it did not work because I have to fight this guy when he's not even there around. I mean, they should be going after you when they're invading. They shouldn't be just be kind of like slaying in the same area. But screw you then, my friend, screw you. I'm just going to have to deal with it. Rock through here, pop a heal aid. My last heal aid off. Hopefully, when I get a decent heal as well, it's going to give me some significant health chunks. And actually, the ability to heal other people as well. Which is dead fine by me. So let's rock through here. I know there's an item coming up on one of these guys. A shivering stone. Okay, then, my friend. Is this an enemy? I don't think it is. You know what? I'm just going to leave this guy. I think there's a way to go through this way as well. Picking up a shivering stone, though. I've got no idea what that thing is. Let's rock through here. Oh, we've got the crow things again. The crow things have returned. Well, these kings actually kicked my ass last time, so let's smash these guys as quick as possible then. Oh my god, I fell down into like some kind of like new area. Nope, smash him. Smash him again. More damage, please. Thank god for that thing going down. Get the hell out of this area. This poison actually ticking me down. I've not really noticed it. Backstab for you. Can indeed. Almost two-shotting the guy. Almost two-shotting him. Yep, actually two-shotting the guy. Almost ain't almost four. He's going down two shots. So these things are like worshipping something. And I'm presuming if I wouldn't have killed that like sorcerer guy, they've done that massive swarm thing. Well, I absolutely kicked my ass last time. Backstab for you. Fine by me, my friend. Any more cheeky backstab for you? Want a little cheeky backstab? Well, I'll take a few little cheeky backstab. Rock through here. No more souls to find? I don't think so. Pretty damn cool area there, guys. Getting wolf's blood opened up. Dead happy with. This poison's still ticking me down. It lasts like 10 minutes, man. Got two of these guys coming up. I wonder if I'm popping off the bow. I might just go for a cheeky backstab. Let's go for a cheeky backstab. Whoa, more like not backstab. My god, check this guy the fucker out. Check my rolls out as well. Check my rolls out. Okay, my friend. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Can't go for the backstab, but actually rolling behind this bitch ass. Kind of fishing for it a little bit, if I'm honest. But you know what? These guys, all these enemies, don't give a shit. They're not bothered about what you do. As long as you don't kill them, then. Whoa, my god. Whoa, my god. Oh, my god. Popping it. Popping Estus. Check this motherfucker down. Check this guy out. He's actually kicking my ass. Absolutely kicking my ass. Okay, what's this thing? Whoa, what's this thing? What's this thing? Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Mushy up. This thing goes down. Sweet. Pillage corpse. Cracked red eye orb, that's actually some kind of like invading thing, but I picked up him out of the question. Cracked red eye orb's like kind of like an invading thing, which I'm dead happy with. Kicking ass at the moment, guys. Kicking ass at the moment. Don't know what the hell's going on. My hunter's out giving me a little bit of luck, but it might just be me going through like the easy enemies. I'm not sure on that one. Let's rock through here. This might be some kind of like secret area that we might have missed out on. Where's this go? Oh, is that a bonfire? Oh, there's a bonfire. Yeah, there's a bonfire, guys. We have found a bonfire. Get in. Bonfire has been achieved. Let's light this baby up. Kind of expecting like some enemies like jump out. Let's rest this bonfire. I don't think we need to go anywhere further. There's a way to go this way now. Yellowfinger's still invading me. I forgot about that dude, man. Kind of want to go after Yellowfinger, but having that bonfire lit, I don't have to worry about it anymore. Where does this area go? This is a new area down there. It might be the same area. Let's backstab this motherfucker. Can indeed. Backstabbing you. Almost killing him. I think one more shot on our little Lothric sword will get us up to a plus 5. One more guy here. Let's backstab your motherfucker ass then. I can't backstab you, so I have to real cheeky damage him. Sweet. With this guy, my stamina roll up. And once again, can indeed. Just sit back down then, my friend. Sit back down. As soon as you get stand up, you've just been sitting there waiting for me to turn up, and then you get your ass kicked for it. And we actually have picked up this crystal thing. This crystal thing has been achieved. We didn't do too bad against these bitches last time. Ooh, I shouldn't be getting real too close. Let's pop my sorcerer staff on. This is how we set up the fight, guys, which I'm dead happy with. Pop an Ash and Estus. Get my magic weapon ready. And let's ditch the staff once again. And let's rock after this motherfucker. So here we go. Damage. Damage. This guy's a little bit more tanky. Has been achieved. Fucking hell. Okay then, guys. Whoa, these crystal things are a little bit like aggressive and like really sporadic as well. Sometimes I can't actually see their movesets. And that thing gets him right by my screen. That was kind of like sucky. Back off again. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Nope. Oh my god, check that roll out. Whoa, that was insane. Pop an Estus. Here we go. Where you at? Nope. And damage. Got some significant damage on him. Down to half health. Okay, my friend, come on, I can do these crystal guys. For some reason I get my ass kicked by the crystal guys normally, but I'm gonna go for it. Got my magic weapon ready. No. Go behind your back ass. Behind your back ass, a little tail swipe for you, my friend. Get yourself kicked ass. Time Knight scale has been achieved, two of them as well, which I'm presuming is going to help me out. I think it's a plus 10 version, gives you a Time Knight scale. And the great magic weapon we have picked up, great magic weapon has been achieved. Get in. Wonder what the attunement is for that. But this is actually back at this area, Road of Sacrifices, yeah. This is where all the crabs are at, and that guy's coming towards me. Let's get the frick out of this area then, Christ almighty. Let's get the hell out of this area. You going to find me? Yep. Oh my god, these things are proper freaky. Proper freaky. And I got grabbed for it. I'm getting like chopped my face off. My god. Take the motherfucker down, please. No. Okay, damage. I love that little damage. I love that stagger blow. Kind of gotten some significant damage on you. Go down, my friend. You go down. So kicking ass at the moment, guys. So I might have to rest at the bonfire and see if we can find Yellowfinger then. Maybe take his bitch ass down. Before we can rest, and you know what, I'm happy with that one. Let's take Yellowfinger down and rest at bonfire finally, because that'd be pretty damn insane. Let's smash all these barrels away. Here we go, items I can see. Don't think there is. Let's go through here and let's go after Yellowfinger, right? I think that's the best thing to do. Only got one Estus flask there, which is kind of a little bit sucky, but I can't rest at the moment. I have to kill this guy, so here we go. Well, I wonder if I'm better. You know what, I might even be better off, you know. No, I was going to say going through the crab area to get to where we were at the start of Farron Keep. See if we can find Yellowfinger, but... Whoa, what? Something was casting spells at me. Something sounded really bad then. Really bad. Whoa, am I getting like some kind of like invisible guy? That's pretty weird. Atonement we picked up. I wonder if that's Yellowfinger casting spells at me. I'm not sure. A hollow gem. Picked up a hollow gem as well now. Where are you at, my friend? Where are you at casting spells at me? And what the hell's all these noises as well? These proper damn weird. Something's casting something at me. I've got no idea. I'm being so blind to this area. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to have to ditch it. Go through here. Get the hell out of this area. I'm going to get poisoned, but I'm going to have to deal with it. Rock through here. I was kind of wanting to pop a magic weapon. Whoa. Sluggy thingies. That's not cool. I'm going to get poisoned. I'm going to get real fucking poisoned. Whoa. Oh my god. Oh god. Poisoned. Freaking hell. Okay, these things are like returning again from Dark Souls 2. These like weird crystal things. Okay, here we go. Damage for you. Awesome. Awesome news. This thing is getting his ass kicked. Getting your ass kicked, my friend. You know what? If I can't find Yellowfinger, I can't find Yellowfinger. It's a bit of a shame, though, because he's kind of blocking me from this area at, completely, really. You coming after me, my friend? Are you coming after me? You ready? You want to deal with it? You want to deal with it? All right, let's deal with it. Smash you out the way. Get your ass kicked, my friend. Get your ass kicked. Let's explore the rest of this area, then, guys. Explore Farron Keep. I know this thing's rolling around here. I kind of want to get Yellowfinger out of the question. But if he's not facing me like a man, I guess I can't find him, man. I'm ready for his bitch ass. I'm ready for it. Pretty strange. Let's pop a heal aid, why not? Pop a heal aid. Get myself back up to full strength. And you know what? I think I might just see if I can find Yellowfinger then, guys, and take his bitch ass down before we actually explore the rest of this area, and maybe just rest the bonfire for down for sure. Nope. I've been poisoned. Pop an Estus. Fucking hell. Backstab. Nope, I can't get it. You know what? I'm just gonna fucking run. Oh my god, this is insane. Run. I'm getting my ass kicked in this area. I'm being poisoned and everything. Oh Christ, I need to like backstab one of them. Backstab, please. Damage. Yo, let's just go fucking go for it. One down. I just need to try and get a backstab on this guy, because if I get a backstab on him, can I go for here? Can I just like smash this? You know, wait, here we go. Oh my god, I missed it. Damn it, I missed it again. Damn it. Please, corpse. Ah, Christ. Pop this one. My health is going considerably low. I've got nothing else I can do. Let's pop this thing on. Back the flings ring on. Actually, you know what? Let's pop the blue tier thing on. It might help me out a little bit. This is kind of sucking my ass, though, because I can't heal at all. You know what? I was going to pop an ember. I can't pop an ember. Crap. Oh my god. Nope. Oh my god. Nope. I'm going to actually die against these freaking minotaurs because I can't heal at all. And bloody Yellowfinger is kicking my ass because he can't get anywhere. Oh Christ, I kind of want to put our blue. Trying to get the bit of health back, but I can't do anything. Is there anything I can pop on? There must be something I can use. Ryan weapon, disable Estus, recovery. You know what? I'm going to have to deal with that. I'm on seriously low health. Kind of go hoping for one backstab, but I don't think I'm going to be able to pull it off. Let's rock through here. I'm on seriously low danger zones now, though, guys. Proper damn danger zones. Can I go for a backstab on this guy? Oh my god, nope. Trying to go for a backstab on him. Cannon this time, got some significant damage on him. Got one more backstab I can get heal off. Backstab, please. Candy, sweet, got a backstab off. This is basically going to give me one heal aid, which helps me out with a little bit of HP. Not much at all. But basically that helps me out just a touch, which is better than nothing, I think, anyway. So I kind of feel like we're missing out on an area, and I almost died to that bloody poison area as well. I don't think there are, though. I think what we need to do is go to where the last, that bonfire is at the last minute as well. I might get my ass kicked by these guys at the top. Let's risk it, I guess. Risk it through here, because I am screwed if I go anywhere in that poison area. I know there's a guy coming up this way. There's like the three combo, I think. Yep, this guy. Whoa, my friend. Whoa. Problem is, the roll gets you so far away. I know it's good for the rolls, but sometimes gets your ass kicked because you get so far away from the guy, you can't backstab him. I could get lucky, though. Could get lucky with one Estus. That's all it could take, right? Let's go through here. Pop a bow on these bitches. Here we go. Popping a bow. Getting you up. Can I get this guy up out of the western? I can indeed. Here we go. Bring you through here. Backstab. Can't. Nope. I didn't get this one, but go for it. I'm a bastard collection. Just need one Estus and I'm good. One Estus. Come on, give me an Estus. Smash this guy away. I know this guy's like the poison guy. Actually, you know what? I'm going to probably just pop this guy on his own. Really wish I could hit that bonfire now, though, guys. All these guys coming towards me. Oh, crap. I brought them both through me. Nope. What are you doing? Nope, I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to do that. Crap. Okay, where are you at? You know what? I'm just going to pop this guy with a bow. A little bit safe than this pretty much. Scanning the question. Popping the purple moss in this guy. So you know what? I'm just gonna pop one of them. If I can get one of these guys at the question, I've got fire eyes. I'm happy to spend them. Nice guy in a little groin shot. Keep firing on you, my friend. Oh my god! Nope. Die, please. Die. Christ, these guys are tanky as hell, and he's just like ignoring me. He's like, what are you trying to do? But what are you trying to do? Mash this guy out of the way. One more shot for you. This thing's going down. One more guy to go. You know what? I'm gonna probably get a little bit risky. If I die, I die. I'm not about that actually. Right, he's coming this way. Rolf is one. Backstab, please. Oh my god, I smashed him with my fist. That was whoopsie. That was proper damn stupid indeed. Proper damn stupid. Whoopsie. My friend. Are we friends? Are we not friends? Let's just do this then. Let's do battle on this little thingy. I always fail on that little shield shot. Rotten Grew Spear and a Rotten Pine Resin. So we got the Grew Spear, right? Let's check this BH out. The Grew Spear. Oh, it actually gives you 34 points into poison. It's pretty damn sweet. And it does look quite cool, actually. I quite like that spear. But, I guess he's kind of like a... Oh, it's got some significant damage on there. Ditch that thing. Quite cool though for like a little bit of a poison weapon. And unfortunately, Yellowfinger still hasn't... I haven't found Yellowfinger anywhere, so I'm kind of either being blind, but I can't rest in this area until I die or he dies, which is a little bit of a shame. So I might have to explore around and see if we can find this motherfucker. Oh my god, I died to slugs. I died to freaking slugs. Come on, man. After all that, I freaking died to slugs. I was getting that low on health, and it just took me one shot, and then that was it. I was trying to get him with a firebomb, but I kind of got my ass kicked. So there's a few things I actually forgot to check up on. I forgot to actually check on that weapon that we picked up. Sorry, that armor that we picked up. But I do know there's actually that one giant crab area, guys, that we might have missed out on. So I want to just hit that crab area, basically in the far corner of that little swamp area. So let's hit back to this, get this armor that we picked up. What was the armor that I picked up? I forgot what it was called. It was like the, was it like the Fallen Warrior stuff, or did we already use that? The Nameless stuff, wasn't it? Yeah, the Nameless Knight armor. Basically gives me the weight. It's pretty much the same, but the, actually check that out. The physical damage is significant, and the versus strike is significantly higher, just compared to the Nameless stuff. What's that like on the old fashioned sword? That's quite cool then. What's like the old trousers like? The Nameless stuff, right? Quite cool then. I quite like that. It's kind of like the Alva set. I think the set of that NPC was wearing. So what were we wearing? We were in the Drang armor and we were wearing the cleric legs. So nope, we're not wearing them ones. We were wearing these ones. Where the hell are you, my friend? Where the hell are you at? Which ones did we wear? We were in these ones, the cleric trousers. So there's one more bonfire I want to hit then, guys. I do need to pick my souls up and we need to hit this last area. Oh, look how many bonfires we've got in this area. Keep ruins. Let's hit this one, because there's one more of that little crab area that we picked up in the corner. Fortunately, Yellowfinger, I don't know where the hell he went. I'm sure he'll invade me at some point, but I, for some reason, can't find him. So I might have to just find this guy off air, go hunt him down in the swamp. But pretty damn sweet. And I can't believe those slugs just ended me just that last minute. Let's just grab my souls then, and let's go after this little thing we saw right in the corner. Okay, so souls has been achieved. Recovered lost souls, 27,000 to spend, which probably should give me probably one level up in faith, which is at least one less down. So we got through here, and then there's like crying crab in the corner, and he's like, weird guys coming out of nowhere. There's like a few of them out, there's a few of them. I've got the right rings on, I don't think. Smash this guy out the way. Two of these bitches go down, sweet. Let's go through here, and this was the Flynn's ring I had on. So this is the thing over here. Poison once again, yeah, I know this. Here's a giant crab thing out. These things are absolutely lethal, and I'm really slow in this area, but I do need to go through this white. There's a white birch over here, yep, this is the white birch over here, which means basically I'm kind of protected. The white birch, I think, signifies the arrow guy. My little archer friend is actually helping me out. Which is awesome news for taking this guy out with some giant arrows and getting me absolute ass kicks. Absolutely ass kicks, he actually saved my life there, my friend. I popped two S's for no damn reason. Pop two S's, okay, damage. And damage get significant damage. Keep damaging. I've got to move. I'm out of stamina. Oh, that claw thing down. Check this great bow attack, great bow bombardment. Artillery strike inbound, right? Artillery strike inbound and he goes down. Thank God for that. Crab, giant crab goes down. These things are tanky guys. Little drain press ring has been. Whoa, freaking out, man. He's dead. Stop firing arrows. He's dead. Calm down. Lingering Dragon Crest ring, though, has been achieved. The Crown of Dusk. Wow, okay then. A young white branch again. Okay then, my friend. And what else are we picking this corner? Soul of a Nameless Soldier. And what else do we pick up? We pick up two more items over here. I am still poisoned. Four S's left to use there. Not too bad. An Ember. I keep thinking every time I look at the S's, I've only got two left because it's the plus two version. It's actually four S's. What we got to do? This one, we have a gold pine bundle. And this last thing over here is the Lost Large Soul from the Trap. So we're getting quite a few of these souls. Let's get the hell out of this poison area. Back to the bonfire, I think. I think I might have to end the episode, guys. But we did get quite a decent progress. Kind of like having a bit of a build set up, really, guys. Right, so let's have a look at this thing we picked up. The Lingering Dragon Crest Ring, I think. and some kind of dust crown, I think. Let's rock back to the bonfire. They're worried nice and safe and warm. Get my feet all warm. Rock back through here and check these things out. So we've got the crown of the dusk. So feather crown bestowed upon the princess of Osile, land of ancient golden sorceresses, through the guardian Elizabeth's blessing. This raises the power and effect of the wearer's magic, but damage suffered by magic attacks rises in tandem. Okay then, my friend, check out my little wings going on. That's pretty damn weird. And what else have we picked up? The lingering dragon crest ring, right? I think this is extends the length of spell effects. It does indeed. A spell given to those who deemed it fit to undertake the journey of discovery in Vinhelm, home of sorcery, extends the length of spell effects. Athropos to the dragon school. The seal depicts an everlasting dragon. A lingering dragon symbolizes the true nature of a consummate sorcerer. So basically, you pop that on and cast a spell. Any like spell effects you cast along, so like a magic weapon or any kind of like buffs, it's going to last longer, which is pretty damn sweet. But as I was saying, guys, we might have to end the episode, I'm afraid. We did get a little bit of progress. Sorry, apologies for the kind of like talking to the NPCs. I thought you guys might want to see that, kind of like going through all the NPC kind of like talks and getting those like new NPC guy, that miracle woman as well, and getting these new weapons as well. Pretty damn sweet. So let me know how you guys got on kicking ass in these kind of areas. Did you guys find Yellowfinger like the bloody undiscovered for me? Because I can't find this guy anywhere, and getting the ass kicked again that guy. But those crystal guys, how'd you get on in that area? But thank you very much for watching, and if you didn't enjoy, please feel free to like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Check out my little wings, man.